In today's video, I'm going to show you how to host a professional virtual conference using the Zoom app. Let's get right into it. So the first thing you're going to want to do here on your desktop is log in to Zoom. The Zoom app is basically ready to go as soon as you start. I would recommend that you take a moment to set up your account and check out the various settings inside of your account. If you have any questions about setting up your account or different settings, type a comment below and I'd be happy to respond to you. Now that your Zoom account is set up and you're ready to host your meeting, there's two ways that you can do this. One of which is you can just simply start your meeting immediately. If you're not ready to start your meeting right now, you can schedule your meeting out for a later date and send the link to your guest. It's very simple. You simply click on your account and then you click on your meetings tab. At this point, you can easily schedule a new meeting, take a moment to write in your topic, a description, your date. If you like, you can set up a password, but it's certainly not required. If you're doing a one-on-one meeting, I like to make things as easy as possible for your guest. So unless it's very sensitive, I would probably recommend not using a password. The rest of the settings are basically good to go as is. So go ahead and save your meeting. Once you've set up your meeting, it's very simple to copy the invitation and send it to anyone. You can simply copy your meeting invitation and email it, message it, text it, however you like. Your guest will be able to join the meeting when it begins and once you've started it. It's important to note, your meeting isn't going to start itself. You're going to need to log into your Zoom account and start it manually before you can meet with your guests. Let me show you how. When you're back in your account tab and you're looking at your meetings, you simply find the appropriate meeting, Lifestyle Savant meeting in this case, you hit your start, and then you're good to go. So let's get into our meeting here. Your computer may have a firewall, just simply click the Open Zoom tab. Before the meeting starts, you're gonna have a couple decisions to make. I wanna preface this by saying you always wanna have headphones on hand. It's definitely preferable to have headphones available before you start your meeting. That way you can prevent feedback and echo type sounds. Before you start your meeting, you probably wanna take a moment to test your speakers and your microphone. Let me put on my headphones. So I can hear the ringtone. If you don't hear a ringtone, just select a different speaker from your dropdown. You want to make sure that you have the correct microphone selected as well. Now that I've gotten my mic and my speakers set up, I'm going to go ahead and join with computer audio. Before our guest arrives, I want to just walk you through a couple of the important features here on the Zoom interface. The first of which is you'll notice that I have mine set up to automatically record. As a podcaster and an interviewer, I always want to make sure that my app is recording immediately. As a side note, if you are recording, you always want to notify your guest that you're recording, but also keep in mind, as soon as they log into the Zoom meeting, it will notify them as well. Let's take a moment and review the various settings from left to right. So the first one we have here is your microphone setting. You always want to make sure that you're set up to use the correct microphone. For example, I'm using the Audio-Technica ATR2100, which gives a nice, clear, crisp sound. I don't want to be using my webcam because the microphone on that is subpar. Again, if you don't hear anything in your headphones or in your speakers, you definitely want to make sure that A, they're plugged in, and B, that you have the correct speakers selected. Now that your audio is optimized and everything looks sounds great, let's take a look at the video. So you can see that our video is set up and it looks pretty good, but let's just take a moment and maximize our video settings. I would typically recommend widescreen in almost all applications. I would definitely recommend that you enable HD to give yourself the highest quality video. If that's not important, you can deselect this and that will probably give you a smoother frame rate. If you're concerned about typing and writing being backwards, you can always enable and disable the mirror effect to give yourself the correct visual. And you can also touch up appearance just to make yourself a little bit nicer looking. The rest of these items are likely going to be fine for you, so you're good to go. All right, so our audio sounds great. Our video looks crispy clean. Let's take a look at inviting our guests. If you haven't already sent your guests an invitation, now's the time to do so. You simply click on the invite tab, and it's going to give you this pop-up. You can email or copy the invitation and paste it to anywhere, whether it's Facebook Messenger, your email account, your WhatsApp, however you want to send it out. Side note, if you don't have it password protected, anyone can join your meeting. So if you're posting it in a public place, just be aware that anyone is going to have access. You've created your meeting and you've invited your guest. Let's see if they've joined yet. It's super simple for guests to join. They simply click on the link you set them and they're good. This can be done both from their computer, their laptop, or their smartphone. Fantastic. Our guest has joined. The video looks good. I can hear him in my headphones. We're ready to rock. You're also going to note there's a few options as the host that you have for controlling your guests. So, for example, if you want to rename them, or maybe they're being loud and you want to remove them, you can do that also. If you find that your guest has some random noise and is disrupting the meeting, you can simply mute and unmute them with this button here. In the side note, you can have a place where guests can type in their chat, or you can welcome new guests. You may find that you need to share your screen, and this is a really handy tool here. When you click on the share screen button, you're going to see a lot of different options, and you simply find the screen that you want to display. Once you've hit the share screen, anything that's visible on that screen will be shared to your guest. If you need to, you can simply stop share, pause share. You can make annotations. Really clean, really simple. In the meantime, I'm done sharing my YouTube page with my guest, so I'm going to go ahead and stop sharing. You'll notice you can very simply pause and stop your recording. If, for example, you're in a large meeting with many people and you agree with something, you might simply hit one of these reaction buttons. You may not necessarily be able to talk, but you can use a reaction to let the speaker know that you're actually listening and engaged. As the host, you can also switch between gallery and speaker view. Right now we're in gallery view, where it's going to show an image of all the guests. You can also select speaker view, which shows a video of the person who is currently speaking. Lastly, Zoom is a really effective and simple way of streaming live to Facebook and YouTube. You simply click on the place that you want to stream to, and it will set it all up for you. It'll link up straight to your Facebook account. Super simple and a really effective way of hosting live interviews on Facebook. Keep in mind, if you're recording, you're still going to have an MP4 video to share on other platforms in the future.
Pro tip, when streaming to Facebook, you want to be 100% sure that you're streaming to the correct page. I have a personal page and several business pages, so you need to take a moment to just make sure that you've selected the proper place to stream.
Listen, it's that simple. As soon as the meeting's done, you simply click end meeting. You can either leave the meeting personally or in the meeting for everyone. After your meeting's done, if you were recording, Zoom is automatically going to start the saving process. When you see this bar hit 100%, another dialog box is going to pop up. We've hit 100%, and now it's time to decide where we want to save our video file.
Listen, Zoom is super simple. There is a lot that you can do with the program, and I definitely recommend it.
I hope you enjoyed this Zoom walkthrough, and if you have any additional questions, please type them below. I'd love to be there to help you make sure that you are hosting and recording the most professional meeting possible. Have a great one.